wish somebody would've told me, babe. Someday these will be the good old days. All the love you forget, and all these reckless nights you regret. Someday soon your whole life's gonna change. You'll miss the magic of these good old days.
I was thinking about the band, I was thinking about the fans. We were underground, loading merch in that 12-passenger van. In a small club in Minnesota, and the snow outside of First Ave. I just wanted my name and a star. Now look at where we at, still growing up. Still growing up. I would lay in my bed and dream about what I'd become. Couldn't wait to get older, couldn't wait to be some. Now that I'm here, wishing I was still young. Those good old days.
It is my pleasure to welcome everyone to the 64th annual commencement of Octorara Junior Senior High School. I would like to express my gratitude to the Board of School Directors, administration, staff, community, and of course the class of 2020 for making this ceremony possible. A special thank you goes out to the parents of the graduates. Without all of your support through the years, this would not be possible. Most of all, I would like to thank the class of 2020. From the first day I arrived in January, you made me feel welcome and part of the Octorara Junior Senior High School family. You will always have a special place in my heart as my first senior class at Octorara. Thank you. I heard a speaker once say that the three B's of public speaking are be bright, be brief, and be gone. One thing I can guarantee you is that I have at least the last two B's covered. After all, everyone is here to see you, class of 2020. This is your time to shine. What a crazy year. I think it's safe to say that none of us envisioned that our school year would come to an abrupt end on March 13th due to a global pandemic. This is definitely not how I envisioned my start, and I'm sure, class of 2020, this is not how I envisioned the end of your time at Octorara. When you are confronted with a situation like this, it's easy to focus on the negative. It's easy to focus on the feeling that you had so much taken from you. When you begin to feel this way, I challenge you to step back and take a look at your journey. The journey that began 13 years ago. Over the years, you've had so many wonderful accomplishments, created memories that will last you a lifetime, and formed relationships that will also last you a lifetime. When I am asked about what type of group was the class of 2020, without hesitation, I will answer, they were resilient. They were handed a situation that none of us have ever experienced before, but they were able to adapt and overcome any obstacle that was put in front of them. They persevered as a group, and in the end, they succeeded as a group. So when you begin to dwell on what you may have lost, focus on the one thing you will never lose, and that is each other. As the shirt you received in your gift bag says, Braves forever. Once a brave, always a brave. You are all brave strong. Congratulations, class of 2020, and good luck.
Hello, everyone. My name is Ryan Carroll, and I am the 2020 senior class president. Before I get to my speech, I would like to address all the parents and guardians of the class of 2020. We could not have done this without you. Rides to tournaments at 6 a.m. on the weekends, picking us up late from parades, attending our extracurricular events, and for always listening to all of our worries and issues. Therefore, on behalf of the graduating class, I would like to thank all of the senior parents and guardians for their guidance and never-ending support. We thank you for believing in us and making us the people that we are today. We are also thankful for the school and the community in preparing and shaping us for the future. Celine Dion recently said, "Life imposes things on you that you can't control, but you still have the choice of how you're going to live through this." This quote applies to everyone, but especially the class of 2020. I know for me, this senior year has definitely not been the one that I could have ever imagined in the way that our world has forever changed. I believe that the class of 2020 is now stronger than ever due to the given circumstances. We are quarantined in our houses, we are attending school virtually, and we have been tasked to find different ways to connect with the people that we care about the most. We have had to find new ways to do all of the things that once seemed normal to us, which we never could have imagined. However, we are making the choice to keep working and keep pushing ourselves to see the light at the end of the tunnel. I believe that one day, we will all look back on this time and find some moments to be grateful for, even though some things can never be recovered. Even though it is not what we had planned, we will forever be a part of this life-changing moment in time. We will rise up from this and be even stronger individuals than we already are. If we can make it through this pandemic, this school closure, and this change in our connection with friends, then I believe that we are truly capable of anything. Congratulations, class of 2020. We did it.
Dear Fear, many believe that you have won, that you have transcended and infiltrated the very heart of human nature, and that you will have the final word. And it seems as if that's true. You have left us scared, broken, and alone, quartered many into what seems to be a bottomless pit with no one to grab onto, drove us into near madness at the thought of anything happening to our loved ones as soon as they step out the door. You seem to be at the heart of everything. Around every corner, disease, addiction, and worldly affliction, and just when it seems that there may be a chance for peace, the evening briefing comes rolling in with the newly deceased. You have left us hopeless and full of hate, telling our generation that we will never equate, never make it into that college, get that job, or do anything worthy of recognition. Left in our division, we rot in our chains. But I know something that I guess you must have forgotten, a fact that history has been well taught in, and that is that hope still exists. It is sprinkled in the innermost depths of humanity, in the lunchrooms, bathrooms, hallways, and text messages. It lies in the small notes, in the good luck pep talks moments before diving into a test, and encouraging glances at a friend you can feel is stressed. It lies in the hugs, smiles, prayers, high fives, and little moments. And it lies in this school. You've trained society to believe that respect is weakness, that love is unachievable, fleeting, and full of pain, but we will not be deceived. Our generation will look to the old with gratitude, to the young with hope, and to ourselves with a level of responsibility for the present. So sorry to ruin your plans, Fear, but I grew up in a community and a school that taught me to be bold, responsible, ambitious, virtuous, energetic, and selfless, and you will not have the final word. For we will take what we have learned, and we will spread the hope that we have all earned. My name is Hallie Englerth, and I am a graduate of the 2020 class.
Good evening, my name is Abby Bear. A friend recently got me thinking about our natural human nature of setting expectations in life, specifically future expectations. Actually, I should say my friend reminded me, because it seems a lesson I have learned and probably will continue to learn over and over. In fact, just last year, my junior year of high school, my grandmother was diagnosed with stage 4 esophageal cancer. It rocked our whole family's world, and reflecting back now, I realize I placed expectations on the outcome of her battle. I expected her to get better. I expected the cancer to lose. And while I'm glad I stayed positive, I was too focused on the future, thinking about how I just always wanted her to get better, which took away from the present time. My expectation of my grandma getting better led to a moment of deeper despair when she lost her battle to cancer. not simply because I lost her, but because I had looked past the present moments we had left. However, I never saw my grandma set an expectation of the outcome of her battle while she was sick. Not that she didn't want to beat the cancer. She just centered her focus on the present moments she was in and cherished each and every one that she had. She has inspired me to do the same, and this was one of the many pieces of wisdom she left with me. Despite my best intentions of living her lesson and not putting expectations on the future, there I was again. This was supposed to be our perfect year of 2020 vision, the year of clarity for our future. Class of 2020, I'm sure many of us had expectations of how this year would go, but reality brought something different to us. If I'm being honest, when I first heard that we were getting 2 weeks off because of coronavirus, I was hype. I mean, that meant no doubt for 2 weeks. I looked at it as a free 2 weeks off with no required schoolwork and a time for to make more memories with my friends. How ironic to think that looking back now. I never thought twice that March 13th, specifically Friday the 13th, would be the last day of attending school in person at Octorara Area High School. All these expectations that I set in my mind of how our year would go is what ultimately led to a worse disappointment. Those 2 weeks off turned into months, which turned into the end of our high school career, and all completely outside of our control. Some of us didn't get to experience a senior night. We never had a chance to walk one more time through the halls of our school. We were stripped from having a healthy way of closure to our school career. No saying goodbyes to the underclassmen, to our teachers, and to our peers and best friends with whom we have accomplished high school. I am here to encourage you today to focus on the present moments and shift those expectations you have for your future into goals. I am beyond thankful for every single one of my classmates. We have shared so many amazing times together, but have also unfortunately endured many disappointments this year. So I hope we can all learn from my grandma's lesson. We have no way of telling what the future holds. Rather than being consumed by what you expect or look forward to happening, concentrate on the moment you are in and shift your expectations into goals for your future. I still found myself constantly consumed with thinking about what would be to come, which resulted in an inability to fully experience the moment I was in. Class of 2020, this is it for us. In a few months, we are all going to be going our separate ways. Cherish your last moments with each other. Be thankful for this moment now of being able to attend a graduation ceremony. As the first day of college approaches, go in with an open mind. Set a goal of what you want to accomplish, but remember to enjoy each moment, rather than placing an expectation on the future. Shift your unique lens to focus your 2020 vision to what is important now, rather than what you want things to look like. This quarantine has shifted my focus to no longer what the future holds and how it might look, but on the present moments each day we live. If we live in the here and now and shift our expectations to goals, the lens we see this world through is going to be immensely brighter. In closing, I want to thank every single one of my classmates, my teachers, my friends, my family, and ultimately God for bringing me to and helping me focus on this moment today. It sounds cliche, but I truly wouldn't be the person I am now without the impact that everyone has had on me. I never expected to be standing here in front of all of you speaking, but through simply slowing down and taking a step back due to COVID, I realized this is something that has been on my heart and I desire to share with each and every one of you. As we take these last moments to celebrate, class of 2020, let's go out with a bang. We are making history, so let's make it one to remember. Thank you.
Good evening. My name is Genevieve Lefever. I feel beyond blessed to be speaking before you all today, even if it is through a screen. I have learned a plethora of things while walking the halls of Octorara these past 4 years, just like many of my fellow 2020 graduates. Things that span from how to take the derivative of a polynomial, to how to adapt to the diverse authors read in my Lit and Comp classes, to how to correctly conjugate a verb in Spanish class, and to how to figure out what to talk about to keep Dr. McWaters off task for making us take physics notes. While all of these learned lessons are of great importance to me, forever being remembered when reflecting back on high school, there's another outlet I discovered I could learn from. In the past 2 years, this outlet taught me truths in life that reign over any intellectual triumphs I've encountered within the bounds of the classroom. The examples I stated before represent my pursuit of achieving a personal goal and expanding my mind intellectually. Early on in high school, I thought this was the utmost important thing in my life. I had to know every answer, and every right question to ask thereafter. I strove for perfection. I thought attaining knowledge would fulfill me as an individual and reveal to me who I am as a person. Let's say my sole pursuit of textbook knowledge was pressuring and draining. The motivation I had behind learning was unhealthy. I was solely consumed about growing my knowledge, rarely broadening my perspective to those around me. My agenda was, how could I be the best in every area of my life? I never intentionally sought out the stories of others' lives. I only wanted to magnify into my own. The way I lived my day-to-day life was self-centered, and it, unknowingly, blinded me from truly finding who I am as an individual. However, during my junior year, after a life-altering heart change, I was faced with a different kind of pursuit in my life, a pursuit for deep, genuine relationships. My sight began to shift to those around me and away from myself. I was blown away, and honestly still am to this day, from how life-giving it is to seek out others rather than yourself, to invest in people and carry their hearts. Through these relationships, I began to discover who I am as a young woman. Number one, I started to see what love truly is. And number two, I broadened my perspective on how life can be uniquely defined for every individual. Choosing to care for those around me, from a family member to a customer at work, imparted that love is a choice. Love is not just based on my circumstance. It also gifted me with the opportunity to hear the mountains and valleys those around me encounter daily, thus refining myself with humbleness. By pursuing those around me first, I was enabled by the redefining of love and exposure to humbleness to then seek out my own personal goals without pressure. Rather, I would pursue with the grace to make mistakes and the modesty to rejoice when I reach an achievement. The reason why I share this personal journey of change from an inward to an outward pursuit is because as humans, we all go through this struggle in life. It's so easy to fall into the staying in our own lane lifestyle, only worrying about ourselves, not having the desire to delve into deep personal relationships with those around us. However, I want to encourage all of us to intentionally seek out these relationships. They are necessary to a full life. Just look at how this pandemic has affected us. What did we miss the most? Seeing our friends, our family, our teachers, and our administrators. It is so easy to overlook the importance of these different connections. I did a poll on Instagram asking my fellow graduating seniors what they loved the most about their years at Octorara. I had hoped that I would receive a diverse collection of responses, such as loving art classes and woodworking shops, enjoying clubs such as Model UN and Student Council, or participating in the athletic programs. However, instead of getting those expected responses, I was actually flooded with answers pertaining to everyone's love and appreciation for the friendships made here at Octorara. After this poll, the truth was affirmed that above all else, relationships are what our hearts need. We are created to grow and learn through people. This is where we discover ourselves, not solely on our own. So, while pursuing individual goals is important, trust me, I can relate to having passions that burn on your heart, pushing you to succeed. We are not able to healthily pursue these passions without the balance and stability of those around us. We need both an outlet of unconditional love and a humbled perspective. These equipped us with wisdom to know how to pursue personal goals absent of greed and overconsumption. Therefore, for the betterment of those around us and for our own selves, we all should choose to pursue different types of people. Rather than putting up walls of assumption and disinterest and turning only to serve ourselves, we should break these barriers down and strive to be in communion with others. The fun part about this is that the dynamics of a relationship can look so different between the many we obtain in life. Don't put any weight on how the relationship should be. Just choose to pursue others with a loving, humble heart and open ears, and then all else will fall into place. That being so, I pray that all listening to these words carry this message with them through the ebb and flow of day-to-day life, that we do not hold against ourselves those weak moments or events in our life where we choose to be selfish rather than becoming, what I like to say, other-centered. That we receive the grace from God and continue to pursue relationships, knowing we can discover more of ourselves through human interaction than through a sole pursuit of individual growth. That we step out of our comfort zone and talk to those around us, even if we do not know them. That we ask them their life story and actually listen and carry their heart. Who knows what we will learn? Last but not least, I pray that we see the strength we have already been equipped with by enduring this virus. Allow this realization to encourage us as we proceed into the next steps of our life, whether that be college, the work field, trade school, or even a gap year. I am beyond proud to be an Octorara Brave with you all. I seriously cannot wait to see how your pursuit of relationships will transform your life and you as an individual through the upcoming years. Go Braves and God bless. Thank you.
At this time, it is my great honor and privilege to introduce some special students in the graduating class of 2020. Before I begin with recognition of specific students, this year's virtual graduation format does not allow us to applaud certain student groups like we normally do. However, each year there is a specific group of students who will soon travel to basic training to begin their military service. We would like to express our gratitude to all of those students who have chosen to proudly serve our country. Now I would like to recognize some individual graduates. We begin with the Octorara's top technical school student. This young lady has taken charge of her career interests in a field where we sorely need competent young men and women, healthcare. Completing Technical College High School's healthcare career and technical program, she has earned a grade point average of 4.25. She will be attending Newman University in the fall. Octorara's top technical student is Sierra Davis. Congratulations. I would now like to introduce the students who have achieved a minimum grade point average of 4.0 or higher, as ranked by their cumulative weighted grade point average at the end of the third quarter of the 2019-2020 school year. This year, there are 24 Octorara students who will be recognized with this distinction. The following graduates are numbers 24 through 11 in class rank, beginning with Abigail Baer, 4.07, Joshua Holton, 4.09, Dawn Schirmerhorn, 4.13, Abby Achenbach, 4.15, Margaret DiStefano, 4.16, David Rudisill, 4.17, Matthew Keating, 4.19, Ryan Carroll, 4.19, Elias Almanza Gutierrez, 4.2, Hallie Englerth, 4.24, Sierra Davis, 4.25, Bryn Watterson, 4.31, Christina D'Andrea, 4.31, Alex Achenbach, 4.31. And now I'll introduce Octorara's top 10 academic students. Carly Rinelli, 4.37. Marissa Maurer, 4.4. Joya Seibeck, 4.44. Michaela Meek, 4.47. Hunter King, 4.5. Emma Reynolds, 4.74. And Thomas Myers, 4.74. It is now my distinct honor to introduce the class co-salutatorians and valedictorian. Salutatorian and valedictorian are selected according to their cumulative grade point average at the end of the third marking period. It is with great pleasure that I introduce our 2020 class co-salutatorians, Abigail Scholes and Alyssa Marsh. Abby and Alyssa both achieved a 4.79 grade point average. Abigail will be attending the Elizabethtown College in their honors program. She will double major in history and anthropology. Alyssa will be attending Ursinus College, where she will be a dual majoring in biology and ethics. Congratulations to both graduates. And now I'd like to introduce Octorara's valedictorian for the class of 2020. It is an honor to recognize Genevieve Lefevre. Genevieve achieved a 4.84 grade point average. Genevieve will be attending Penn State University in the fall, where she was admitted to the Schreyer Honors College. She plans to major in civil engineering. Congratulations to Genevieve. And at this time, we will begin recognizing all of our graduates.
Taylor Marie Dean. Bethany L. Griffin. Kirby Seltzer. Brian L. James Jr. Josh Amaral. Anthony Georgette. Colin M. Sansini. Bryn Watterson. Naya Starkey. Christina D'Andrea. Brian Burr. Caden Salata. Verna Trainer. Matthew G. Keating. Colby M. Wrigley. Thomas Myers. Cade Hamm. Ray Brown. Rodney Dixon Jr. Rachel Cecily Davis. Taylor Lundstra. Riley Knuckles. Abigail Bear. Brandon Patrick Gordon. Anthony Falutor Jr. Ricardo Gonzalez Flores. Nathaniel Paul Sellers. Sean William Foster. Keith Lamont Lambert Jr. Ryan Elizabeth Carroll. Abby Achenbach. Melissa Mercado. Jansen Shemp. Ben Pappas. Nick Roy. Jimmy Genzano. Lexi Julius. Adriana Kitana. Leah Fromm. Nicole Elizabeth Miller. Tatiana Caraballo Healy. Xavion Boyer. John R. Miller, Jr. Jared Haven. Olivia Danae Pauley. Kirsten Renee Manis. Ronald Ferrara III. Mason Kiersnowski. Alexis Werner. Shelby Prankin. Sierra Davis. Selena Chanel Williams. Catherine Cohn. Mia Salini. Krista Leanne Outland. Sanjuana Silali Rios Perez. Lizeth Sari Castaneda. Damian C. Dill. James Anthony Tygelski. Tegan Elizabeth McDonough. Gary Goins Davis. Alyssa Marsh. Ben Pratt. Jason Brown. Leah Laffey. Ryan Jensen. Josh Linenbaugh. Haley A. Kohler. Cesar Gonzalez. Analia Rose Waldron. Dave Barrett. Kyle Fernandez. Ryan Dorbich. Nick Mattingly. David Robb. Victoria L. Manson. Logan Donald Forte. Damon Hanby. Adam Rudisill. David Rudisill. Michael Rudisill. Lucas Salada. Zach Hall. Mara Siobhan Schenk. Madison Catherine Bristow. Abigail Scholes. Maggie DiStefano. Carly Rinelli. Wyatt Humble. Joseph Michael Valentino. Lacey Moore. Destiny Campus. Marissa Lynn Rosenbaum. Evan Michael Montgomery. Thomas Michael Melma. Thomas Jacob Prusak. Jeremy James Real. William Peter Gallagher. Matthew Busby. Tanya Medina. Austin Rutledge. Sierra Wayne Burgos. Anai Romero. Caleb Samuel Studebaker. Brandon William Baker. McClay. Asia Purchase. Jenna May Orblinski. Audrey Milligan. Hunter Sloan King. Jamira Brown. Emily Davis. Caitlin Aline Kepler. Emma Hoffman. Isla Inez Mendez. Peyton Grace Bromley. Caleb McComsey. Miguel Zavala Cruz. Antonio Renteria Mojica. Lauren Elizabeth Stauffer. Dominic Cates. Jack M's. Luis Zavala. Nicholas R. Miller. Charles R. Belmonte. Savannah Griner. Thank you. Austin Ott. Austin Troop. Ryan Edwin Wheeler. Jasmine Riker. Beckett Walters. Dylan Smith. Devin Renee Bird. Iv Strayer. Amber Marie Rapp. Alyssa Elizabeth Rapp. Veronica Lopez Gonzalez. Nicholas McCall. Joseph Kuhn. Hallie Englerth. Marissa Marie Maurer. Savannah Jo Pluck. Samari Yaroline Zavala. Olivia Hawthorne. Caitlin Romanek. Lucas P. Thompson. Genevieve Lefebvre. Anna B. Zavala Martinez. Emma Reynolds. Roxana Gonzalez. Jennifer Gonzalez. Billy Moore. Joseph Pizzolatto. Seth Ryan Engel. Joya Seebeck. Abigail Losey. Aubrey Lonsinger. Josh Mendenhall. Yelady Mario Garcia. Connell Smith. Stacy Biermeister. Callan Rachel Carr. Mario Vargas Garcia. Dawn Nicole. Kylie Rose Shirk.
Yeah, Kylie!
Brianna Niemont. Michaela Jean Meek. Jada Salsius. Jada John William Russell. Carla Justine Seema Doyle. Alejandro Perez.
Family, friends, administration, staff, board of school directors, and especially graduates of the class of 2020. It is an honor and a privilege to share this moment with all of you. From your childhood days, you might recall A.A. Milne's The Many Adventures of Winnie the Pooh. Christopher Robin, Pooh's trusted friend, shares, "You are braver than you believe, and stronger than you seem, and smarter than you think." While it would never be my wish to have your senior year disrupted in the manner in which it has been, I can't help to think that Christopher Robin's advice was meant for you during this challenging time in your young lives. This year, you have displayed perseverance in the face of adversity. You have shown us that flexibility is a virtue in a world that is constantly changing. You have learned that poise is an essential skill that reaps many rewards. You have shown that strength and determination can overcome challenges. And finally, you have shown that sacrifice can strengthen personal capacity. You are braves in every sense of the word. I speak not only for myself, but for the entire school community when I share how proud we are of all of you. And now, by the authority vested in me by the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania, it is my honor and privilege to certify to the Board of School Directors that the students whose names were called this evening in the presence of their families, their friends, and their school community have met the requirements for a high school diploma as established by the Pennsylvania Department of Education and the Octorara Area School District. Congratulations and best wishes, Octorara Class of 2020.
Hail to thee, dear alma mater, we with reverence sing to thee. Of our love and our devotion and our faith and loyalty, we will cherish and remember all the knowledge we
in that 12-passenger van in a small club in Minnesota, and the snow outside of First Ave. I just wanted my name and a star. Now look at where we at, still growing up.
still growing up. I would lay in my bed and dream about what I'd become. Couldn't wait to get older, couldn't wait to be some. Now that I'm here, wishing I was still young. Those good old days.
I wish somebody would've told me, babe, that someday these would be the good old days. All the love you won't forget, and all these reckless nights you won't regret. 'Cause someday soon your whole life's gonna change. You'll miss the magic of the good old days.
Wish I didn't think I had the answers. Wish I didn't drink all of that glass first. Wish I made it to homecoming. Got up the courage to ask her. Wish I would've gotten out of my show. Wish I put the bottle back on that shelf. Wish I wouldn't have worried about what other people thought and felt comfortable with myself. Rooftop open and the stars above. Moment frozen, sneaking out and falling in love. Me, you and that futon, we just begun. On the grass dreaming, figuring out who I was. Those good old days.
I wish somebody would've told me, babe, that someday these would be the good old days. All the love you won't forget, and all these reckless nights you won't regret. 'Cause someday soon your whole life's gonna change. You'll miss the magic of the good old days.
Never thought we'd get old. Maybe we're still young. Maybe you always look back and think it was better than it was. Maybe these are the moments. Maybe I've been missing what it's about. Been scared of the future, thinking about the past while missing out on now. We've come so far, I guess I'm proud. At night, worry about the wrinkles around my smile. I got some scars, I've been around. I felt some pain, I seen some things, but I'm here now. Those good old days.
You don't know what you got, whoa, whoa, till it goes, whoa, whoa, till it's gone, whoa, whoa, you don't know. These good.